we shall now prove fundamental theorem on homomorphism of groups. In group theory, homomorphism and isomorphisms are significant to study the relation between two algebraic systems, firstly introduced by Galois with the study of polynomials, has applications in physics, chemistry and computer science, and also puzzles like the Rubik's Cube, as it may be expressed utilizing group theory. Homomorphisms is both a monomorphism and an epimorphism, maintaining a map between two algebraic structures of the same type, such as two groups, two rings, two fields, two vector spaces. And isomorphism is a bijective homomorphism defined as a morphism which has an inverse that is also morphism. Accordingly, homomorphisms are effective in analyzing and calculating algebraic systems, as they enable one to recognize how intently distinct systems are associated. Let us recall some of the results which we learned already. The first one is the definition of quotient group. If N is a normal subgroup of a group G, then the set of right cosets of N in G forms a group with respect to the multiplication of cosets as binary operation. Here we can also consider set of left cosets of N in G. This group is called quotient group or factored group. It is denoted by G divided by N. So G by N is equals to set of all elements of the form N A such that A belongs to G. That is, the quotient group consists of all right cosets of N in G generated by the element A. The coset multiplication is defined as H suffix A, H suffix B equal to H suffix A into B. HA is the right coset of H in G generated by A. HB is the right coset of H in G generated by B. That is equals to HAB, that is right coset of H in G generated by the element AB. If two right cosets of H in G generated by A and B are equal, if and only if AB inverse belongs to H, where H is a subgroup of G and the two elements A and B are elements of G. Now we shall prove that every homomorphic image of an abelian group is abelian. Proof: let G comma dot be an abelian group and G dash dot be a multiplicative group. Let F be a function from G to G dash, be a homomorphism onto. Therefore, G dash is the homomorphic image of G. Now we have to show that G dash is also abelian. For this, let us consider A dash comma B dash be two elements of G dash. Now, to show that G dash is abelian, we have to show that A dash into B dash is equals to B dash into A dash. Since A dash comma B dash belong to G, there exists elements A comma B belong to G, so that F of A equal to A dash and F of B equal to B dash. This is by definition of onto. Since G is abelian, we have AB equals to BA. Now consider A dash into B dash. By definition of onto, we have F of A equal to A dash and F of B equal to B dash. Therefore, A dash can be written as F of A, B dash can be written as F of B. What is F? F is a homomorphism. That is f of a into b equal to f of a into f of b. Therefore, this f of a and f of b can be written as f of a b. What is a into b? A into b is nothing but b into a by equation number 1. Therefore, this is equal to f of b into a. Then what is f? F is a homomorphism. Therefore, f of b into a can be written as f of b into f of a. What is f of b? B dash. What is f of a? A dash. Therefore, that is equals to b dash into a dash. Thus, a dash into b dash is equals to b dash into a dash. Therefore, g dash is abelian. That is, every homomorphic image of an abelian group is abelian. Here, g dash is the homomorphic image of the group G. Therefore, it is abelian. We shall now prove fundamental theorem on homomorphism of groups. The statement of the theorem is, every homomorphic image G dash of a group G is isomorphic to some quotient group of G. We are given every homomorphic image G dash of a group G. Therefore, this gives a function, say f from G to G dash, which is homomorphism on to, and this is isomorphic to some quotient group of G. Or we can state that if f is from G to G dash is on to homomorphism and the K is a normal subgroup of G, then the quotient group G by K is isomorphic to G dash. Proof. Let f is from G to G dash be on to homomorphism. Let K be the kernel of f, then K is a normal subgroup of G. A kernel of a homomorphism is always a normal subgroup of the group G. Therefore, G by K is a quotient group of G by K. Now, we have to show that this G by K is isomorphic to G dash. We have to show that the quotient group G by K is isomorphic to G dash. For A belongs to G, consider this a group G and consider an element A in this. KA belongs to G by K. If A is an element of the group G, then KA is a right coset of K in G generated by A, that must belong to the quotient group G by K. Consider the group G by K. Here consider an element KA. Thus, for A belongs to G, we have a KA belongs to G by K, and F of A equals to G dash, because F is a onto homomorphism from G to G dash. Consider the circle as a group G dash. Therefore, for this A, F of A must be in G dash. Consider this a function F. Therefore, F of A must be in G dash. Consider the mapping phi from G by K to G dash. This G by K, this is a group G. Therefore, there is a function phi from G by K to G dash, such that phi of KA is equals to F of A. Phi of KA is equals to F of A, for A belongs to G. Thus, A belongs to G implies KA belongs to G by K. Also, if A belongs to G, since F is a onto homomorphism, F of A is in G dash. Now we are going to relate G by K and G dash by using a mapping phi. Therefore, phi of KA is equals to F of A. Thus, this theorem consists of two functions. They are F and phi. F is given as a on to homomorphism from G to G dash. Now we are defining a function phi from G by K to G dash. Now we have to show that this phi is isomorphism, or G by K is isomorphic to G dash. Thus we have two functions, namely F and phi, and three groups, namely G, G dash, G by K. Now it is very clear that elements of G are of the form A, B, C, D, so on. Then the elements of G by K of the form KA, KB, KC, KD, so on. That is, KA is the right coset of K in G generated by A, and KB is the right coset of K in G generated by the element B of G, so on. That is, G by K consists of all right cosets generated by the elements of G, and the elements of G dash are of the form F of A, comma F of B, comma F of C, comma F of D, so on. Here A is from G, therefore its image F of A under the function F must be in G dash. B is from G and its image F of B under the function F is in G dash, so on, where F of A equals to phi of KA. This structure, this diagram shows that there are two functions F and G and three groups G, G dash and G by K, and we can also know the structure of the elements of G, G by K and G dash. We are going to show that G by K is isomorphic to G dash. For this we have to show that phi is well defined. Since all the elements of the right coset KA possess the same phi image, namely F of A, which is the single F image of the single element A in G. Therefore, it is necessary to prove that phi is well sure, a function is well defined. We'll be using this idea, that is, F is from A to B is well defined if A equals to B implies F of A equal to F of B for all A comma B belong to A. That is, if any two elements of the domain sets are equal, then their images must be equal. Then we can say that the function F is well defined. So to show that phi is well defined, we have to take two elements from the domain group, namely G by K. We know that the elements of G by K will be of the form KA, KB, so on, and assume that these two elements are equal, then we have to show that phi of those two elements must belong to G dash. The KA and KB from G by K, and assume that KA equals to KB, then we have to show that phi of KA equals to phi of KB. To show that phi is well defined, we consider KA equal to KB, then we have to show that phi of KA equal to phi of KB for all A comma B belong to G. We shall now show that phi is well defined. For A comma B belong to G, KA comma KB belong to the quotient group G by K, and assume that KA equals to KB. Now we have to show that phi of KA equal to phi of KB. KA equals to KB, that is, two right cosets are equal. Whenever two right cosets are equal generated by the elements A and B of the group, then we must have AB inverse belongs to the subgroup. Here K is a subgroup of G. Right coset KA equal to KB, and this must imply AB inverse belongs to K. Also, we know that by definition of kernel, if K is a kernel, then f of x is equal to e dash implies and implied by x belongs to k. That is, if x belongs to k, then f of x is equals to e dash. This implies f of ab inverse equals to e dash by the definition of kernel. And remember that k is a normal subgroup of the group G, and f is a function from G to G dash. Therefore, we write f of AB inverse equals to E dash. What is f? F is a onto homomorphism. Since f is a homomorphism, we know that f of A into B equal to f of A into f of B. Therefore, this can be written as f of A into f of B inverse equals to E dash. We also know that f of B inverse is equal to f of B whole inverse. This is one of the properties of homomorphism. Therefore, the above one can be written as f of A into f of B whole inverse is equals to E dash. Now, we have to eliminate this inverse. For that sake, we are going to post multiply it by f of b. So, post multiply it by f of b. Also, we know that f of b whole inverse in the f of b is equals to identity. And the f of b belongs to g dash. And the identity in g dash is e dash. Therefore, f of b inverse in the f of b equals to e dash. Therefore, f of a into e dash is equal to e dash into f of b. And we know that if you multiply any element with the identity, we get the same element. Therefore, this implies f of a equal to f of b. What is f of a? By definition of phi, phi of ka equal to f of a. Phi of kb equal to f of b. Therefore, phi of ka equal to phi of f of b. Therefore, ka equal to kb implies phi of ka equal to phi of kb. For all a comma b belong to g. Therefore, phi is well defined. We shall now show that the function phi is 1-1. Phi is 1-1 if phi of ka equal to phi of kb implies ka equals to kb for all a comma b belong to g. That is, to prove that phi is 1-1, this is the reverse process of well defined. Or we can say well defined is the reverse process of 1-1. That is, to show that any function is 1-1, we have to consider image of two elements equal, then the two elements must be equal. Now consider phi of ka is equal to phi of kb, because some of them pronounce this symbol as phi. So phi of ka equal to phi of kb. By definition of phi, phi of ka equal to f of a for a belongs to g. Therefore, we must have f of a equals to f of b. Post multiplied by f of b inverse. F of a into f of b inverse is equals to f of b into f of b inverse. And we know that f of b and f of b inverse both belong to the group g dash. And the identity in the group g dash is e dash. Therefore, f of b into f of b inverse is equal to e dash. This implies f of a into f of b whole inverse is equals to e dash. Since f of b whole inverse is equals to f of b inverse, this can be written as f of a into f of b inverse equal to e dash. What is f? F is a homomorphism. Therefore, f of a into f of b can be written as f of a into b, and hence f of a into f of b inverse can be written as f of ab inverse, that is equals to e dash. By definition of kernel, we know that f of x is equal to e dash, then x must belong to the kernel of f, namely k, and hence here f of ab inverse is equal to e dash, and hence the element ab inverse must belong to the kernel, namely k. This implies ab inverse belongs to k. Also we know that ab inverse belong to h, where h is a subgroup of a group, then ha is equal to hb. That is, ab inverse belongs to h, then the right coset of h in g generated by a must be equals to the right coset of h in g generated by b. Therefore, ab inverse belongs to k implies ka is equals to kb. Thus, phi of ka is equals to phi of kb implies ka equal to kb for all a comma b belong to g. That is, the function phi is 1 to 1. Thus, we have shown that phi is well defined and phi is 1 to 1. To show that it is isomorphic, we have to show two more things, namely phi is onto and phi is homomorphism. Now, the third part is phi is onto. We know the definition of onto. If f is from a to b is onto, then for every b belongs to b, there exists a belongs to a, such that the function is true, that is f of a equals to b. To show that some function is onto, we always choose an arbitrary element from the codomain set, that is b belongs to b. For this element b in codomain set, there must exist at least one element small a in a, that is a in domain set, such that f of a is equals to b. To show phi is onto, since phi is a function from g by k to g dash, which is defined as phi of k a equal to f of a for a belongs to g, we have to prove phi is onto. For this, we have to select one arbitrary element from g dash. That is, for every x belongs to g dash, there must exist one element in g by k. That is, there exists k a belongs to g by k, such that the function is true. That is, phi of k a must be equals to x. So now we are going to choose one element x from g dash. So let x belong to g dash. Since f is from g to g dash is onto, for every element in g dash, there exists an element in g, such that the function is true. Since we have taken already x belongs to g dash, for this x from g dash, there exists an element a in g, such that f of a equals to x. And for this a, k a is a right coset of k a in g generated by a, must belong to g by k. That is, k a belongs to g by k. And so phi of k into a is equals to f of a by definition of phi. But what is f of a? F of a equals to x, which belongs to g dash. Thus, we have chosen an arbitrary element x from g dash. For this x, there exists an element k a from g by k, where a belongs to g, such that phi of k a is equals to x. Therefore, phi is onto. To prove phi is onto, we have used the hypothesis, namely f is from G2, G dash is onto. Now the fourth part is homomorphism. Now we have to show that phi is a homomorphism. By definition of homomorphism, then f of a into b equals to f of a into f of b for all a comma b belong to G. That is, we have to choose two elements from the domain group, namely G. Here, what is the domain group? In phi, the domain group is G by K, that is the quotient group. Take two elements from G by K. Let us take KA and KB from G by K. To prove phi is a homomorphism, we have to show that phi of KA into KB is equal to phi of KA into phi of KB. So for A comma B belong to G, always we have a KA comma KB belong to G by K, where KA and KB are the right coset of K in G generated by the elements of A and B. Now consider phi of KA into KB. We know the coset multiplication is HA into HB equal to H into AB. Here KA and KB are two right cosets. Therefore, KA into KB will be equals to phi of KAB. By we know the coset multiplication is defined as HA into HB is equal to HAB, where HA and HB are the two right cosets of H in G generated by A and B. Therefore, here KA and KB are the two right cosets of K in G generated by A and B respectively. Then their product will be equals to K suffix AB. Therefore, this is equals to phi of K suffix AB. By definition of phi, what is the definition of phi? Phi of KA is equal to F of A. But here phi of KAB is there. Therefore, this is equal to F of AB. F of AB. What is F? F is a homomorphism. That is, F of A into B equal to F of A into F of B. Therefore, this can be written as F of A into F of B. What is F of A? By definition of phi, F of A equal to phi of KA. What is F of B? By definition of phi, KB is phi of KB. Therefore, that is equals to phi of KA into phi of KB. Therefore, phi of KA into KB is equal to phi of KA into phi of KB. That is, phi is a homomorphism. Thus, we are shown that phi is well defined, phi is 1 to 1, phi is on to, and finally, phi is a homomorphism. We know that a function f is from G to G dash is an isomorphism if the function f is 1 to 1, on to, and homomorphism. Therefore, here the phi is well defined, as well as the phi is 1 to 1, onto and homomorphism. Therefore, phi is an isomorphism and G by K is isomorphic to G dash. Hence, G by K is isomorphic to G dash.